You know, I think mentoring is so important. And so this is the authenticity about it, right? Because you can say, oh, I want to tell you what to do, or I want to help you with decisions like a coach. You know, I think about mentoring as just like a coach. People are coming to you because they really, again, it starts with trust. And so you're going to take care of them. You're going to nurture them. You're going to help guide them into solutions that they may not have thought about. And so you're really the one that's keeping someone accountable and then helping them make those critical decisions that they need at really important times in their life. And so it can be, you know, major decisions or little decisions, but having that person there that's on your side, that's not related, that is not a mother, father, sister, brother, that can be a confidant and can be your advocate. And so I think mentoring in the workplace is one thing, because you say, okay, you know what my best interest is for my career. Here's the things that I want to do. Mm-hmm. Or outside of the workplace, they really need to understand what the journey is that you're seeing, that you're envisioning, right? It's not their journey as a mentor. As a mentee, you have to be able to communicate, this is where I want to go, and this is where mm-hmm. I need your help. And I think that's the key. Can you communicate clearly the expectations from each party? And so that's how you get the most value out of that relationship. And he said to me, are you sure you want to share my story? Right? Yeah. And that's exactly the kind of person that needs to share their story, because what's happened to him in the last 3 years, so this is the third year of the podcast, and he was show number one. And he now has started his own journal. He started his own kind of series for people to watch his clinical trials, and he's trying to do the Ironman and has really started to walk through this recovery. He still is a survivor, but he is so strong in what he believes about how he can take care of himself and the strategies that he's using every day in his life. And that's where I'm on the sidelines just celebrating him, because it's his attitude of how he's going to attack his life and encourage others. And there's so many stories like that, that have just, you know, people come to me, they come through other people, but I look at them and I say, wow, what an amazing attitude that you have. How have you conquered the things in your life? And I'd love to share your story. It's so many people, right? They've rebranded themselves. They have gone from not believing. And again, when I talk about the first segment of the series, I opened it up with, you know, many of these people, you will understand how they all connect to each other. And it was all about their beliefs, because most of them believed one thing. And as they transform their life, they begin to believe something different. And I think that's the journey that we're all on. And that's how we become an everyday leader, right? We start leading others in that way. First of all, it comes down to trust. You have to develop a foundation of trust, because if someone doesn't trust you, they're not going to believe anything that you say, nor they're going to follow you. And you can take that from your parents. You know, as you were raised, you think about your family. If your mom or dad told you to do something, you did it because you trusted them, and you would get in trouble. There would be accountability to it if you didn't follow the rules. But it goes beyond that, right? The people that you start developing relationships with as you grow in school and in careers, you know, if you find something out that you can't trust somebody, that is that changes your whole opinion about how they're going to influence you. Mm-hmm. And what they say really doesn't hold any value to you. And so that's where I believe the biggest takeaway about influence is lying with who we can really trust authentically.